Hey there, this is a quick little video about my experience of using macOS Big Sur on an old Ivy Bridge Hackintosh. This is not a Big Sur or OpenCore tutorial or a review. I will just share my experience of using this machine for nearly 2 weeks. If you don't know my configuration, here is it. I will do a neo fetch too. I'm using an Ivy Bridge i3-3220 with ASRock H61M S1 Plus motherboard with 4GB of RAM and an MSI GD710. By the way, this is a GK208 variant which is recommended in Dotena guide. For the GPU, I have given the Amazon affiliate link for those who are interested. I am saying so because this is the cheapest natively supported GPU that you can buy right now to use in your Big Sur build if you looking for a cheapest card. Okay, let's talk about how it performs. On the first day or two, it was as expected. Everything was as usual. On the third day, I had a kernel panic, which is the same one which I had on Catalina. Then I made some research. I patched out the IRQ using SSDT times and generated a SSDT HPET and added some patch data to APCI section in my config file. As you can see here, I have added a SSDT HPET SSDT and some IRQ patches in the patches sections too. Also to mention, I could not able to unlock the CFG lock, which would also impact this. Unlocking the CFG lock on my motherboard requires a modded BIOS, but I don't have any kernel panic after patching the IRQ. I'm not 100% sure that my system is 100% stable or whatsoever. During the first few days, I also had weird issue of random logouts, but after patching the IRQs, it seems to be stable, but you never know. The software is not designed for this hardware anyway. So don't use this machine for important work and don't rely on this machine to save some important documents or some important data. Anyhow, I have been using this machine for editing 1080p videos for a few months now, and I have also encountered many data losses. Right now during recording this video, I have lost the first take of this video. This is the second take. You need to be conscious and you need to save your important documents on a separate external hard disk or somewhere safer. If you could unlock the CFG lock on your motherboard, just do it. It will improve the stability of your Hackintosh. If you are rocking an AMD Hackintosh, there is no CFG lock whatsoever. If you are wondering how to do it, I will provide the link for the guide in the description below. I will not use this Hackintosh from December 2020 because I bought a new machine, but I will update the EFI of this machine until OpenCore 0.6.4. Then I will not be updating anything regarding this Hackintosh. Regarding the new machine, I have a NUC Hackintosh build coming up on this channel. I will try to make better and detailed guide by using that. So if you like to watch that, hit the subscribe button along with the bell icon so you don't miss that video when it goes live. If you want me to update the Hackintosh past 0.6.4 for this exact configuration, raise a GitHub issue on the Hackintosh Catalina project, for which also I have given the link in the description below. For my Hackintosh friends, I have two little handy open source software for you. The first one is Rectangle, which is a window manager. As you might know, macOS sucks in handling windows on the screen. It will just clutter on the screen. So I'm using the app called Rectangle, which is a fork of Spectacle, and because the Spectacle is deprecated, so the Rectangle guys took that code and they have developing it for a while now. So this is a cool window manager. As you can see, it works like the magnet, which is a paid app from the app store. This one has the same functionality as like that. So if you are not aware of this, give it a shot and I hope you like it. And the second one is something called Monitor Control. This is used to control the brightness of any monitor which you hooked up to your machine. It may also work on some official Apple machines too. The beauty of this is you can control the brightness. If you have built-in speaker with your monitor, you can control the volume too. And I have two monitors connected to this system. In some monitors, you can also adjust the contrast ratio. The keyboard shortcuts on your keyboard also will work. I don't know whether you can see the brightness change in the video. If you can't see that, sorry for that. The keyboard shortcut on your keyboard will work if you are using an official Apple keyboard, or if you have a Windows keyboard, just figure out the exact keys on your Windows keyboard with the similar functionalities, or just remap the shortcut system preferences panel. I will provide the links for these two softwares in the description below. If you guys have any app suggestion like these or any some other cool apps, please let me know in the comment section below. I will show you the GitHub pages for these two open source apps. This is the page for the rectangle. Just go to Google and search for rectangle GitHub project. This will show up, and this is the GitHub page for monitor control app. Everything is recently updated, and the community is active and they are developing the software. Just go to the releases and grab the software and install it to your Mac. And this is that easy. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you like this video, hit the like button. Also to mention, I have planned many open source projects for this channel. If you are interested, subscribe to the channel. Stay safe and catch you guys on my next video.